everybody. This is MM ASMR. And I am so sorry that I haven't been around recently. I just had a really, really, really busy week. Everything is good. I mean, nothing bad happened. It was just busy between my PhD and some art stuff and just some other deadlines and things, but I can't complain. But I felt really bad because I haven't made a video for you in so long. So today we're going to do color tests and eye exams and a little bit of an interactive guessing game and some tracing. Let's just get right into it. So, to begin with, I recently purchased a packet of paints. These are 30 paints, which is amazing. Let me get my trusty pointer here. And look at all of these colors. There's brown and red and orange, yellow, green, teal, blue, purple, pink, kind of beigey skin tones, brown, and then there's black and white back here. So, this was a set of 30 acrylic paints, and they were only $10, and they come with a little brush and a mixing tray, so I thought that was such a good buy. So, if you turn this over, you will see that there is a list of all of the colors, and I thought what we could do, first and foremost, is count them. Make sure that they're all represented, and then after we count them, go through the names. So firstly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So all 30 colors are represented. Now, let's go through the names of each color. Titanium white, black, burnt sienna, burnt ombre, yellow orchard, unbleached titanium, blush pink, flamingo, fuchsia, red violet, lavender, purple, primary blue, cerulean blue, sapphire blue, cyan blue, aqua green, teal, forest green, permanent light green, lime green, yellow green, canary yellow, primary yellow, marigold, cadmium orange hue, burnt orange, scarlet red, primary red, crimson. So let's take a look at these colors. Is this color lighter or darker than this color? That's darker. And between this color and this color, which one is darker? This one, yes. Between this color and this color, which one is lighter? Yes. Between this color and this color, which one is lighter? This one, excellent. Which one is darker, this color or this color? This color, yes. Which one's brighter, this color or this color? This color, yes. And is this color darker or lighter than this color? It's darker, yep. And is this color darker or lighter than this color? It's lighter, Is this color darker or lighter than this color? you have a favorite? And why is that? Okay, I see that. I can never pick a color. As an artist, it's really hard for me to pick which colors I like the most, because I love all colors. And I don't do a lot of tapping or scraping on my channel, but you guys find this relaxing? Because if you do, I will certainly try to incorporate more tapping, scratching, into my videos. Like, is that annoying? Or does it sound nice? You have to let me know. There's so many of you now that it can be really tough to figure out what to include and what not to include, because everybody has slightly different triggers. And there's so many of you. This is wonderful. Sometimes I find them intimidating. But I love seeing my channel grow. I'm so happy it's gotten to this many subscribers. So, any of you that have watched my channel for a while will recognize this chart. It's from one of my most popular videos. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to point to certain things, and I want you to tell me what shape and what color you see. So if I point to this, you'll say yellow circle. If I point to this, you'll say red triangle. And anything that's like this, like a sideways square, we can just call it a diamond, okay? So let's begin. Red square, yes. What is this? Yellow circle, yep. And this? Yellow triangle, excellent. This? Green triangle, yep, very good. This? Purple diamond. Blue diamond. Yes, a pink circle. Absolutely fabulous. This one, green triangle. Purple square. Purple diamond. Okay. And this one, blue square. Yep. Excellent. This one, red diamond. Yep. Blue star. Yep. And this one, purple square. Very good. A triangle, yep. Yes, a green triangle. A red triangle, yep. Excellent. This one. A red circle, yep. And a pink square. Pretty good. So now I'm going to start tapping really fast. And I just want you to keep up as I'm tapping, okay? And just tell me what you see. So I'm going to go very quick. Very good. Yes. Super. Okay, you're doing superbly. Endless. Okay, excellent. So unsurprisingly, you didn't have any trouble with that chart, because you never really have trouble with those charts. So now the next thing we're going to do, we're just going to take a little break from the charts, and then we'll take out this piece of construction paper, and I am going to trace some words on this, and they're going to be in all capital letters. So I just want you to follow along as I trace, okay? What word is that? Lamp. Very good. What word is that? Ball. Yep. Very good. What word is that? Movie, yep. Zoo. How about that one? Lion. Excellent. This is a tough one. What's that? Shrimp. Yep. Yes, UFO. Okay, one last one. What's that? Area 51. Yes. Keep with the whole alien theme. Very good. Okay. So now, I have gathered a couple of pins here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 pins. They are all different colors. And they make some really nice sounds. Nick, let me know if you enjoy the clicking and the sounds. Okay. So each one of these pens is a different shade. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to move them aside, and I want you to watch this space. And at some point, you're going to see the pens come into the screen. And when you see them come into the screen, I just want you to tell me what direction it's coming from and what color it is, okay? So watch the screen. Watch the screen. Keep watching. What color pen do you see? It's orange. And what direction is it coming from? Right. Excellent. Okay. Keep watching the screen. Keep watching the screen. What? Yep. The direction. Down, yep, or it's coming up rather. And it's coming up from the bottom. And what color is it? Light blue, yes. Very good. This one. It's coming down from the top, yep. What color is it? Pink. This one. It's red, yep. What side's it coming from? The right, excellent. Color's this? It's purple, yep. What color? What side is it coming from? The left, yes. Very good. Now what color is she using? Orange and green. And what sides are they coming from? Right and down coming up. Very good. And what colors do you see? Purple. And blue. And are these light or dark purples and blues? Light, excellent. We have a lavender and a sky blue. And what direction are they coming from? Yes, they're coming from the left. And from the top coming down. Very good. What color is this? It's light green. What direction is it coming from? The bottom, yes, the bottom coming. I'm doing well as usual. So I'm just going to place my hands here. And I want you to tell me which hand is moving, and how many fingers I'm holding up to represent a number. Okay. Let's begin. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yep. Mm-hmm. Two on the right. Yep. Four on the left. Very good. One on the right. Yep. Three on the right. Yep. Two on the left. Yep. One on the right. Three on the left, yes. Four on the right, yep. And can you see which hand has the palm up and which hand has the palm down? Mm-hmm. Right side, palm is up. Left side, it's down. And this side, we have the left side now has the palm up, and the right side, the palm down. Very good. So you had no problems there. And I am sorry if anybody's watching from Ireland or England or Australia, because I know that sometimes the Americans consider to be the peace sign means something kind of rude in British English and Irish English. But I'm sorry, it's not meant to be rude. Okay. This seems like a rude sign to you. It's supposed to be our peace sign, so just be aware of that. Okay. So now, I want to share with you some very special items that I got in today for review purposes. So I don't know if I've mentioned this before, but I review toys and games pretty frequently for my job. And today I got in this adorable little dog toy that could also double as a toy for a toddler. And it's a little toadstool. It's red. All these white dots. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Little toad, little dots on it. And it is so cute. And it has 1, 2 little windows in it. But then, it also comes, and I have to be careful because these squeak and it would make a very loud noise and would scare anybody trying to watch this video to relax. But it comes with these two adorable little elves. So they are identical. They're both wearing green with red hats. I kind of wish one was in blue, one was in green, just to differentiate them. But actually the green is cute because it kind of reminds me of Christmas. I like Christmas elves. But look at them, they're so cute. They have green outfits on and red hats, and they have white beards. And look at the way the faces are stitched in a more shiny material. And they even have these little black shoes on. I just thought they were so, so cute. Them in their little toadstool house. With the 8 white circles on it. And the 2 little gnomes. These 2 gnomes need a name. So if you think, or we need names rather. Look at even their little arms. So in the comment section, if you would like to take a crack at naming them, please feel free to leave your suggestions. I really kind of want them to have names that kind of match in some way. I don't know how better to explain that. Just something that is kind of befitting. But they both fit into their little house. And I just thought that was so cute. I just wanted to share that with you. So anyway, now we have come to the the final portion of this video. This video is not going to be as long as some others because it's already 3 o'clock in the morning here and I have a few more things to do aside from uploading this video before I can go to sleep. I'm quite tired myself though. What I have here is a little rabbit and the little carrot. Now these are very cute little wooden pieces. Oops. I got these as part of a game set that I found in the 99-cent store around Easter. And I just think they're adorable. I will be recycling them into some artwork. Probably some art that I'll wind up giving to like a rabbit rescue organization. So an abstract piece with these little identifiable features in it. A rabbit and a carrot. So we're going to take a little look at this. So we have this white bunny. And it's a girl bunny. See her eyelashes, how feminine she is. And she's got these cute little ears with the pink on the inside. And a pink nose. And pink rosy cheeks. And little black whiskers. And beautiful eyes. And a cute little mouth. And over here we have an orange carrot. With a green leaf. Oops, slipped off my hand. Green leaf. And 1, 2, 3 little stalks on the lettuce. And then the carrot has some lines. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 outlining it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put these to the side. And I want you to close your eyes and relax. And when I tell you to open them, you're just going to tell me if you see the bunny or the carrot. And if you want to guess which one you're going to see, you're welcome to do that. But this is more about you just being able to identify when I ask you to open your eyes, rather than trying to guess ahead of time. If you want to guess ahead of time, feel free to do so. So, close your eyes. Close your eyes. And open them. What do you see? The bunny or the carrot? The bunny. Very good. Now close your eyes again. Close them. Close them. And open them. What do you see? The bunny a second time. Very good. Okay. Now close your eyes. Close your eyes. Yes, the bunny a third time. And this time she's upside down. Silly bunny. Now close your eyes. Close your eyes. And open them. And yes, this time you see the carrot. Very good. Now close your eyes again. Close them. Bunny once more, yep. Now close your eyes again. Keep them closed. Keep them closed. And open them. What do you see? The carrot. Okay, so close your eyes again. Keep them closed. Keep them closed. And open them. What do you see? Tricked you that time. There's the bunny and the carrot. Very good. So as usual, there's nothing at all wrong with your eyes. You're doing very, very well. Your eyes are good and your cognition is great. So thank you for watching this video, even though it's a little bit shorter than some of my others. And please do check back to my channel soon. Morning.